We think so much alike.
Hello, guys. We are the 8-Bit Badgers. And today we are going to play some Plants vs. Zombies and kind of do a little podcast style video. So we hope you enjoy it.
So we're a week away from E3. And there's a lot to look forward to, hopefully.
Hopefully.
A lot of stuff has been announced recently.
It's gonna suck.
No disappointments.
No new games. Yeah. No nothing.
Like, last week we had Fallout 4 was announced, finally.
I think everyone was excited for that, even if you've never played Fallout.
After, 7 years, right?
I just hope that they do probably something like, new.
It was worth the wait.
New Vegas came out in, like...
New Vegas wasn't a Bethesda title, though.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I'm just scared. I don't know if... I haven't heard anything new, anything else about it. But I just hope that it's not same kind of thing as the last one. I know it's going to be along, you know, along the same lines, but I'm excited to see what they do new with it, and I hope that they do enough new to, besides just a new location,
like
with brighter colors, you know what I mean?
Yeah, no copy and paste and stuff.
Yeah, because so far that's really all it looks like.
Well, we haven't seen it yet.
I know, we haven't seen anything about it, but it, just from the trailer, that was my first impression. It was like, kind of looks like Fallout 3, just brighter.
Yeah,
well, and about the trailer itself,
I mean, same armor too.
It was like actual. It wasn't CGI or anything.
Yeah, that was an engine. Very,
also, the armor was there to kind of be like, oh shit, we're here, because that was like was like the popular armor of Fallout 3.
Yeah,
it was more. True. I don't think that's gonna be like a big basis in Fallout 4, like using that armor. It's more just like a little end of the video, like, oh shit,
it's the armor.
We're here.
Yeah, I can get it.
Because that little armor just hanging up in the garage is like, yeah. Oh.
The power armor. Oh, you're talking about power armor?
Yeah, the power. No, okay. Because
you were saying how the armor's the same. It's not like that.
Yeah.
I thought you were thinking the vault armor.
There's only so like intricate they can get with different armor, considering it's supposed to be a little realistic.
Yeah.
It's not like it's fantasy. I mean, it is, but it's not. It's hard. It's like realistic fantasy, I guess. I don't know. It's weird. Mm-hmm. But it's in a different area. It's in Chicago this time, right?
Mm-mm. No. Boston. Like,
where is it? Boston.
Boston. Which is actually more interesting than DC, in my opinion.
Yeah, it is.
About the trailer itself, compared to, like, for example, we had The Division.
What do I do?
Where it's a lot of, like, CGI or kind of, like, those bullshit.
Pre-rendered
videos.
Everything's CGI, but yeah.
This seemed more like...
No, this
they've been working on it for a while. And
this is, yeah, that was all in-engine. Like, that was, like, yeah. I guarantee we'll see a release date this fall. My Skyrim came out, when it got announced, it got announced a year or 11 months beforehand, and that was a pre-rendered cutscene for like building hype. It was like the one where it's like the one he feared, Dragonborn. That one,
yeah.
Like, that was like a year before the game came out. But now that we're seeing this game, like announced, probably 6 months, and it was like, because okay, Skyrim, we got an in-game Skyrim trailer at E3. The year or 6 months before it came out, so I'm assuming it's gonna be the same track, because Bethesda is really good at keeping like the same formula for everything.
Mm-hmm.
So I guarantee that we'll see this pretty soon, hopefully.
I'm stoked for it. Considering...
I'm actually one more point, but speaking because it's in engine, and people are complaining about the graphic fidelity, but honestly, it's probably the one first like true game that's come out so far that's not gonna overhype the graphics and then disappoint everyone. Like, oh my god, it's a downgrade.
Honestly,
yeah.
All the past Fallout games, I know they've been around for they're kind of older.
Oh, my god,
oh wow,
the lag.
They're older in general, but like,
great.
Fallout 3 wasn't like great graphics, but something about it, the graphics the way they were, made it the way it was.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh yeah,
about it. Oh wow,
back up this game and find a new one.
I'm just saying from my point of view, and a lot of people are going to give me shit for it maybe, is considering I've never finished a Fallout game, it's going to be nice to like be in the loop, hopefully, with the whole game as the process is going, because I never finished Fallout 3. Played probably 10 minutes of Fallout New Vegas and didn't care for it.
Which I swear by. I keep telling you to play it.
What, Fallout New Vegas?
Did you love Fallout New Vegas?
I love New Vegas.
I got stuck
in
that one.
And Fallout 3.
The one part in Fallout New Vegas where you walk into that area and there's like that roller coaster and shit, I always got stuck there. There was one room where you had to walk down in, and every time I walked in, everyone turned me into freaking cheese. I had holes everywhere.
I don't know.
I need to play that game again.
Yeah, so Fallout 4, definitely probably my most anticipated game for E3.
This is probably the best year for, honestly, because last year I said it's the best year for games, but I turned.
It keeps getting better.
I turned into I turned into the name of the year of disappointment, because everything got overhyped and everything ended up breaking. There was not a single game.
PlayStation 4.
Yeah, let's not get into PlayStation right now.
Hey, ow. It's a great game now.
It was broken as shit, okay?
It's still a great game.
That was an utter disappointment.
It was broken.
The Order 1886?
No.
Master Chief Collection.
Yeah, but it's still broken. I played it last night.
It was better than it was at first.
Oh, yeah, at least I can actually play multiplayer, but as opposed to when it first came out.
All right, so back on topic. Fallout 4, right? I think everyone can agree with the fact that it's probably one of the most anticipated games so far.
That can be dangerous, though, too. So.
I'm more excited for Fallout at this point than I am for Battlefront.
Oh. Battlefront, but still. Oh.
We'll get to that next.
Yeah, like,
I'm excited for Battlefront.
I'm excited for both, but I don't know. The way they announced it.
Fallout?
So confidently. And, like, they have, like, Bethesda has, like, a full...
hour.
Like their own conference.
They have like an hour, don't they?
There's a rumor of like having like 30 minutes of gameplay for Fallout alone. There's some really weird things about Fallout. Have you actually read the details about what they announced?
I don't read things.
Well, it's actually not. It's not announced. It's a leak. I don't read things either.
I don't either, honestly. I just like, play video games.
I tend to look at an article, and if I see like more than three paragraphs, I'm like,
TLDR,
basically. I wait for Evan to like chat and him like see if he brings it up and he brings it up and I'm like yes.
Whenever I message anyone about games, it begins with like games that I'm stoked for.
Dude, did you hear about this?
It begins with dude. Like, period.
and then I'm always like, I saw it, but I didn't read it.
Yeah. So I have to explain it in like layman terms and I'm like, well, this is going on.
Damon's terms.
So, so yeah, basically, derpy.
Simple and easy, just how I like you.
I agree.
Okay, so
I'm dying.
Next topic.
Wait, I was gonna say one more thing about Fallout. What was the one thing I was gonna say about Fallout? Oh god, I broke my train.
You fell out of thought?
Your train?
Oh, the leaks. There's weird things about the like. So there's a supposed leak that happened about 8 months ago from a Bethesda employee, and she pretty much she got fired for leaking details in an accident. So revenge for Bethesda firing her. She leaked the Fallout 4. Basically, most of the stuff that's come out so far has been true.
Spoiler.
Yeah. Boston location, voice acted main player. Did you catch that, by the way?
Yeah.
At the end of the trailer.
Yeah.
Guess who it is? It's yours truly, Troy Baker.
Really?
Once again. You can hear the voice.
I don't know the voice at all.
Like, it's exactly what he said. Like, come on, boy.
Is it confirmed?
It's Troy Baker. Yeah, that has to be Troy Baker. There's no one else that sounds like that.
If... No, I mean, I'm not trying to sound like an idiot or anything, but is that character right there going to be the main character
then?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
But which brings up an interesting point. If he's the main character and he has a voice, can you not have a female character?
Yeah, can you customize in this one?
I wonder...
Because that was a big part of my...
I'm sure you will be able to have a female character, and there must be another one that we don't know about.
Which is what makes sense, but then the leak said that there's only a couple story missions that you play with Troy Baker, or whatever you want to call it. Troy Baker, Vault Boy, whatever.
So is it going to be different perspectives?
Maybe he could be like a companion of some sort.
Do we die? Yeah. Do we die like right away and get to pick a new character?
Maybe, because like apparently, like I said, somewhere like half through the game, you're done with Troy Baker, and then you had the customizable options, which makes no sense to me.
Yeah, that's really strange.
See, because like the leaks sound really plausible up to that point, but then again, like voice acted character, like they could pull a whole.
Is it going to be like Red Dead, where it's like you're John Marston, but then you have a kid and you play as your kid?
Maybe, but like the only thing, like what I can think of is like Mass Effect, because Mass Effect had like a male main character and a female main character. The problem is that Fallout has so much dialogue. And it depends on your stats as well. Like, is your speech high enough? Like, are you, like, is your intelligence high enough? Like, the best thing...
But you know what? Honestly, that's what's keeping it so good for me right now, is that we don't know.
Yeah.
That little clip and all the leak, and we still kind of know nothing about the game.
Yeah.
You know nothing, Jon Snow.
One thing I...
You wrote nothing,
like,
Jon Snow.
In that trailer they showed off, a lot of it did look like it could be, like, gameplay or... like places that we may end up going in.
I guarantee you, yeah.
But that includes like they in the trailer, if you haven't seen it, they've showed
seriously?
They showed Boston before
and after
it was bombed and then after. Well, yeah. So what if there's a possibility that we do play it before it gets bombed? Well, or you actually even they even show like a bomb going off. So what if that's actual?
And that's what I'm saying. So what if it is like Red Dead Redemption, the baby being born thing? Because it showed the dog going in that house and looking in the crib.
Right.
What if the baby is actually the main character, and you play as John Marston, like, kind of like either right before the apocalypse or during the apocalypse, like right when it happens. Or maybe that's why he's walking around. So it shows him a bit.
Opening mission shows you the world. Bomb goes off. Now you have to learn the new world as a new character, maybe?
Yeah, that's kind of...
It'd be kind of different.
People are making theories about the vault. The vault is probably a cryogenics vault. Because every vault is a scientific experiment.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like, you got the Garys.
Because wasn't Vault 101, like, just kind of like nothing? It was like...
There's a little certain niche to it. I think it's like dictatorship or something like that.
Yeah.
But, like yeah, if you remember all the other vaults, like... Like, you didn't play New Vegas, but New Vegas had, like, actual physical experimentations where it's, like, this one literally experimented with plant technology and how it could be adapted for humanity. And
that's
like,
where I got stuck, because I got creeped out playing it.
That's what the people in the... People. Yeah, it's creepy.
The what?
There's a little vault in New Vegas. Actually, if you're going to play it, I'm not going to tell you.
No, I've played it before.
Okay, but there's a vault in New Vegas where it's, like... There's plant people. They go into the vault, and there's a bunch of it's overgrown plants, and there's people hide like in cocoons,
they're
and they break
shit,
out.
Dude.
Yeah,
damn.
But then like
Little Avery was scared to shit.
Little Avery.
Wasn't there one where there was like there's a very surreal. I remember going into it might have been a vault or just some neighborhood or something in Fallout 3 or 4 New Vegas. I can't remember which one, but it was very surreal. Like everything was kind of. Kind of, it felt Twilight Zone-ish.
Oh, that's yeah. It's the one where everything's in a alternate, not alternate, a simulated reality.
Yeah.
And it's like the one chick, the little girl.
Yeah.
And she's the mastermind.
I remember that was really like eerie when I played
and
it. I was
they like break out of it.
Weird.
To break out of it, you had to either find the failsafe code or you had to like kill everyone.
It. That was so
that's,
good though.
That's what Vault 101 was for. Was to be closed indefinitely to basically test the. Like, how people react, like, in like, close quarters.
Mm.
It was never supposed to be open, even if nothing went off. Even if there's no bomb, even if things were fixed, that was supposed to stay closed.
That's
even
crazy.
Though it was open many times, which is why it's infested by rad roaches, yeah.
Yeah, you're right.
Which is crazy to think. That was supposed to be closed, yet it was open, like, a shit ton of times.
That's why I love the universe, because, like, everything about it is so unique, where it's like...
Honestly, I'd love to see a Fallout movie.
The culture stops in the 50s, but technology moves on.
Avery, shut up.
That's fucking cool.
Yeah.
There's 50s are an amazing
like,
time.
Yeah.
Like, the basic game in the 50s. Like,
yeah. Not
shit.
Really an amazing
no,
time.
No, not an amazing time, but just, like, the 50s is such an interesting time.
That's...
You know?
Yeah.
That...
It's a birth of a lot of things.
That time healing, period
yeah.
alone is what creeps me out so much about that game. Every trailer they've ever had starts off with an oldie, like, old-time song, and it's always really mellow, and it, like, it almost gives me PTSD. And it's like...
It's amazing how well it parallels.
It's beautiful. They're so good at,
Like, isn't the reasoning for, like, having the vaults in the first place was, like, the Holocaust or Cold War?
The Cold
like
War,
that?
Yeah. Holocaust, no.
Because I remember, seeing a poster, because, like, I didn't play Fallout 3, but since they announced it, I started watching someone else's
playthrough.
Oh, dude,
this is so bad.
Yeah, this is really loud.
And it said, like, prepare for the Holocaust, unless they're talking about, like, a future.
The nuclear.
Like,
nuclear Holocaust.
Yeah. But, yeah.
The nuclear Holocaust has
been... I'm so excited, though.
Boundaries.
Now that we've talked about it, I'm even more excited.
Yeah, it's just, like... all the weird concerns aside, I'm still like I'm still blaming. Like I, it's funny because like there's the whole motive right now where it's like don't pre-order, wait for the final release.
I'm
like if you're excited for something and you want to put your money towards it, feel free.
Well, yeah, but I mean, my thing with pre-ordering is that like you're gonna get it anyways.
Right.
Pre-ordering doesn't do anything anymore. It used to.
Yeah, like if you went to GameStop.
Unless you get like so you get like little tiny things now for pre-ordering, but more often than not, if you just go buy it day one, they're still gonna give you the pre-order bonus.
Oh yeah,
like that happened to me. Like for I think it was.
This is really laggy.
It was Far Cry. For Far Cry 4, I got all the pre-order bonuses from GameStop, and I didn't pre-order. I went in and bought it day of.
Well, yeah, lately in like the past year or two, they just
give
the pre-orders.
Give it
if you get it like within the first week.
Yeah,
you get most
give
bonuses.
Well, so which is why, but I mean, but that's at least if you buy it like a day of or day after, you'd at least get those first day reviews.
Right.
But
so
I
you're not
I was referring to
the more Master Chief Collection.
But
mishaps.
My thing is, I agree with Evan. If you're gonna buy it anyway, what's the difference if you pre-order it or not? You're not spending more.
Yeah,
yeah, and I don't sell my games. I buy everything digital. So I like even if I regret it. there's no way for me to return it, so.
Yeah. I don't care. I think it's more of a fact that, like, when you pre-order a game, you're basically telling the developer, no matter what you put out, you still get my money.
I guess. Well, that brings up a
that's not true,
interesting
though.
Thing.
That's actually not true, though, because, like, the... So, okay, sorry, I'll let you get to your point, but, like, when you pre-order a game, that money does not go to the companies. They see the numbers, but that money goes to the GameStop or Best Buy or Target.
What percentage goes to the game?
No, the $5 that you put, $5 that you put in ballers, $5 you put in the they put in the pre-order doesn't go to the actual like
no,
the
I know. Business. But I mean, you're basically telling them, like, no matter what you can put out complete shit, and I'm still buying it. Mm-hmm. I've already committed to buying this game before I even know what it is.
Yeah,
that's what happened with the Master Chief Collection.
But my question is, do they see all the returns? Do they actually see, like, oh, no, shit, we're getting a lot of people selling this game back?
I'm sure the approval rating goes straight down.
They'll see it on the servers. If they have server stuff, they'll see how many people are and who isn't. So, I mean, pre-order, like I said, it doesn't really matter because they'll see it in their numbers. They'll be like, oh, shit, we got a lot of pre-orders, but we also got a lot of people saying this game sucked dick.
It's just like, it's basically giving support before support is earned.
Yeah. It's mostly the publisher's fault, too.
Yeah.
Like...
Yes.
EA was a freaking like golden example of how bad it got when that was a really bad delay. But like the past year, they've been like turning out like really good games and like polished games. Like surprisingly enough, this game like was really polished. it was a really polished game. Well, it is still, but it's just really laggy.
It's really laggy right now.
Yeah, but this game came out of nowhere. Like I saw it and I thought it was a joke. Cause like it was like whatever, like, it was a Battlefield trailer, like, but with Plants vs. Zombies, and I was like, this is silly. This has to be like an expansion or something like that, or a joke. But no, this game came out, and I was like, I bought it, and then like I told Connor, I was like, you have to get this game, cause this is probably the funnest like shooter that's on the next gen consoles right now.
Oh, new.
Sorry, that was a really bad side.
I'm gonna backtrack a little, but like, so you're saying, like. There's not as much of an incentive to pre-order as there used to be because it's like you could get a digital.
I don't think there's any early.
There's, well,
except for maybe like I just got paid and I don't know if I'll have the money by the time when the game comes out.
Well,
so I'm gonna put the money into it now.
The Witcher did something interesting where if you had the first two games and you pre-ordered, you got like 10% off, or like 15% off.
Yeah. That's because CG Project Red is literally a group of Swedish geniuses, like. The guys are
pick a game.
Did such a great job with that game.
Like a different game.
Well, speaking of The Witcher, there's two things here. I did pre-order The Witcher 3, and because I pre-ordered it, I was able to pre-load it.
Peggle.
So I downloaded like a week early, and then when it was released, I could just play it. But I could see like why it would be bad like if.
Oh, you're stupid.
Like, in there's been times like for example, I pre-ordered Destiny.
Yeah.
And I did it digitally. And then when I didn't like it, I couldn't return it. However, I don't know if you heard, but like Steam, I think this last week.
Oh, yeah, you told me this.
They announced that their new refund policy.
Actually.
It's basically a no questions asked refund for your game. So, for example, let's say you bought Evolve. I was just reading a story on someone's story on Reddit, but someone bought Evolve at launch and put like maybe 2 hours into it and didn't like it and didn't play it. Six months later, now that they have the new refund policy, they requested a refund. And even though it was 6 months later, they gave him a full refund, $60.
That's amazing.
Damn. For a digital game.
That's pretty cool.
And so,
good job, Slade. Good job.
That's but like the first before,
game they did in a while.
I would argue the same thing. Like the only incentive to like
to pre-order, is pre-order, to
preload, and then like they have like some games have incentives.
Yeah, yeah,
like,
if they give you
bonuses.
Like...
But I mean, honestly, when it comes down to it, if you pre-order disc, it's not gonna matter because if you don't like it, you take it back in the next day, right? You have 30 days to take it back for full price.
Yeah.
So I mean.
Not with GameStop, you take it back the day later. If it's open, you get 40% of what you paid for.
Then they changed that. It used to be like you get your full price if you don't like it. Then you go to Target. I honestly GameStop.
Yeah, I don't
Target and Best Buy are a way better trade-in.
Jared bought Destiny, went home, he couldn't download it because he always had technical issues. Took it back the same day, and they were like, is it opened? And he's like, of course it's opened. And they're like, oh, okay, well then we'll give you
$40 for it. And I was just like, and I went in there and I was like, no, he bought this, like, he just had technical difficulties and he couldn't return it. And the guy was like, all right, well, like, I'll make an exception for this. And it was ridiculous.
But I honestly think with that, they actually can give it to you for full price. They just choose not to because it looks better on the, it looks better on their part for when they actually work. But no, no talking shit to gun game stuff. Anyway, that's not the point of the, this podcast.
We're not even on the point of the podcast.
No, we're not.
So far away.
Let's talk about games now.
Okay, no. Let's go by conferences. So, because we looked up like conferences, it'll be easier. We got them right over there, actually. We got the list of the conferences on the computer.
So, conferences. I mean, we touched Bethesda a little bit.
So, Bethesda is actually good, because that is... Bethesda... Okay, let's finish with Bethesda. They got, Doom. Doom's coming out.
I know nothing about Doom.
I know nothing.
Doom should be interesting. I played it a bit as a kid on the PC, and it was fun and hard.
So what are they? Is it like a remaster or is it
a new game? It's an entirely new.
Is it going to be like Duke? Not Duke Nukem. That game's terrible. Wolfenstein. Yeah. Because I know in Wolfenstein you could play either like the old Wolfenstein, like the, there's a little Easter egg.
Yeah.
So I mean, I wonder if they can do it like a Wolfenstein kind of thing where it's like you actually, it's like a first-person shooter, not. It's going to be a first-person shooter.
It's just a reboot, what?
Honestly. Because it's not Doom 4. Is it Doom 4 or is it just Doom?
Let me see.
I don't know if either's or like probably just if they've confirmed whether either or if it's either.
Yeah, that's fine, Connor. I can't speak. Look
I guess we'll find out. But
yeah, we'll find out by the time.
Anything else from Bethesda, cool. Right? Nothing from Bethesda.
I can't really think of anything else. Maybe like an expansion for Elder Scrolls Online.
Oh, I don't doubt that.
Like, yeah, that's probably
because especially now that it's on Xbox and PlayStation 4 or Xbox One.
Has anybody played it?
No, servers crashed.
Are they still down?
I didn't play it this tomorrow or today.
At the point of filming this right now, it came out last night.
Yeah.
But this will probably go
blue. We should actually say the date. This is the...
Today, yeah, today's... I don't know what the date is.
Today is
June 9th.
Tuesday, June 9th.
I had to write it like four times.
10 at work. 10 at night.
We're 6 days away from E3.
If you made it 30 minutes into the podcast and don't know what day it is, congratulations, you're a trooper. We just added context way too late.
But, all right, well, then let's move on to Microsoft.
All right.
I think I'm probably the... I don't know. I want to say I'm the most excited, but...
No, you are. Don't even lie. You are.
Don't sugarcoat it.
Halo 5 is coming out. You're just like...
Oh my god, I can't...
Did you read their announcement today?
Yes!
See? Oh my god. I told you right now. That's all it took.
There, that's all
it took.
That's our answer.
I haven't heard anything about it.
So it's so pretty.
Okay.
Did you see the renders?
I didn't see anything. I just read that they're now... What is it? 5 DLC?
Oh my god. Get this. So they announced everything about the multiplayer. They said that within this next month, Game Informer has exclusive rights for releasing details about Halo 5.
Really?
And so they did a full detail on the campaign a campaign mission today, and it's exactly what I was talking about before. Remember how I was saying the guy from Republic Commando is the project lead on this or the lead designer? Totally right. He's working on it, and the game is a four squad based first person shooter now, and so
wait what?
Yeah.
Wait.
So you play as Master Chief, and you have three side people that play with you.
And same with John. And same with Locke.
And same with Angel
Locke. Locke has Team Osiris.
Is it what you were talking about? How Locke's hunting down.
Do you mean play with other people?
No, it's
so
like
co-op and offline. So yeah, you can like AI companions that you play
so
with.
So that you can play with four friends, basically.
Yeah,
three friends.
And they hop into those characters.
That's really cool.
And so the characters have unique armor. Player like styles and loadouts.
Interesting.
And so
like Assassin's Creed was supposed to be.
Yeah. So like basically like they're all the Chief's team is actually from the I'm gonna geek out from the lore. That's pretty much what I'm gonna say.
I told you.
They're from the lore and basically they're all Spartans and they have their unique abilities. So like Linda is a better sniper. So when you play as her, you start with a sniper rifle at all times.
Right.
That's so nice.
And so it's same with all the other characters. Like close quarters have shotguns and stuff. But basically, you play as Chief in the main campaign, and you can bark orders, like attack orders and move orders. your characters using the D-pad now.
Yeah. Which, honestly, if we're playing with friends, I'm not going to do that. We're just going to basically just bail in if someone dies.
But someone said it's really hard now.
Really? Like, the actual campaign?
Yeah. The Game Informer said the campaign is really hard because have to use squad tactics to win. And,
so I'm never playing alone then.
And so, you don't die. You don't die in this. You fall. You get
incapacitated.
Incapacitated. And you're on the ground. You have to get waited for a revive. And so, just like Republic Commando, your squad members can come over and resuscitate you.
So what happens if your whole team dies? You just restart. So that's basically death. Yeah. Okay.
Which is really cool.
Yeah.
That's something I didn't think I wanted in Halo, but it actually is.
So now you don't have to wait for checkpoints for everyone to be revived. That's actually nice.
But
it's like a Tom Clancy game, dude.
Yeah. So they basically...
We'll get to that eventually.
They made it harder in a good way. Like, there's actual skill required where it's like... Like, right now it's like...
Strategy.
Like, Bobby and I were running through, like, Lasso or something like that. He died. I have to wait for it to respawn or something like that. Now I can just go actually revive him and not wait for when the game decides to revive him. And one more point about Halo 5. They also announced that there will be 20 maps at the start.
20? No, and then...
20. And then... And then by June 2016, there will be 15 plus additional maps for DLC... For free.
Completely free.
Free.
For online.
Yeah. For online.
That's incredible.
All they need to do is add a horde mode, like, that's what do you shit my pants.
That is amazing. Like, that's like, they're doing everything they can to be like, guys, we're sorry for the Master Chief Collection.
They kind of needed to, though.
Yeah, but like, honestly, like, someone put in a great perspective, like, the Master Chief Collection is a giant shit stain that they'll never get rid of on the Whitey Tidies.
Yeah.
Like, I saw that on Reddit.
People constantly give them shit for it, but I don't really care.
But they can do, like, Billy Madison and make it look cool.
Yeah, like, honestly, if they have one, like, being mistake...
is cool.
If they have one mistake, that's all, like...
What the fuck?
Have you guys not seen that?
No.
Billy Madison?
Yeah, Billy Madison. He goes back to school.
One little kid pisses his pants, and he pours water in his pants, so it looks like he pisses his pants. Like, he's like, peeing your pants is cool, guys.
All the cool kids are peeing their pants.
And then all the kids start
peeing
their pants.
Yeah, and all the
fucking...
They're like, hey, Billy peed his pants. Nice, man. They give him, like, a fist bump.
You need to watch Billy Madison.
It's such a great movie. Dude, they had a freaking Billy Madison and Happy Gilmore marathon on... Or not marathon, but they just played them back-to-back a couple weekends ago. It was so nice.
That's a big-ass marathon, just playing back and forth. All right, so what are you talking about now?
What'd you just do? Did you just pee your pants? I think you just spit
like regurgitated Coke. He's like, wow,
it's okay.
That's cool.
Don't confuse the Cokes.
Hey, does someone want that one's empty.
Sure. Okay.
There you go.
I forgot to put
okay, so yeah, no Halo beside. Gears of War is a remaster. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's only the first one. That's what I've heard. So it's only a remake of the first. And then...
Wait, a remake of the first...
Or a remaster, sorry. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm getting distracted by Sunset Overdrive.
Of the first Gears of War?
Sorry.
Yes. Yes. So it's like... It's like... They're basically doing the same thing with the day with the Master Chief Collection for Halo 2, where it's like, oh, it basically looks really pretty because it's like, what would we have done if we made the game today? Like, that kind of thing. And so basically, it has all these.
Doing anything else?
I don't know.
Well,
they haven't
announced
it.
Yeah,
well,
I guess.
This is all rumors. And then what else is Microsoft? Dragon Scale? Green Scale?
Yeah, what is that?
Well, didn't they?
Oh, that's the DJ shit, huh?
That's the DJ, the Dragon Slaying. Like, someone said it could possibly be like the Xbox version of Monster Hunter or Microsoft's version of Monster Hunter.
Oh, Bobby's gonna shit his pants, yo.
Wait, what?
So, what is the name of it?
Like a dragon who does DJing or something?
No, it's like you're a dragon rider. And you hunt other dragons with your dragon.
No, we're only seeing DJ because in the trailer the kid had
headphones like,
on. Didn't they show that last year? The
yeah, they did.
Let me see here.
I kind of remember that.
Yeah, where they basically he slides at the top of the big dinosaur.
Green scale?
It was something. I thought it was green.
I don't remember.
I remember the color.
Scalebound. Scalebound. Yeah,
that's what it was.
I'm confusing Game of Thrones. No spoilers. If you didn't hear me, no spoilers. let's see. Quantum Break has been confirmed not to be there.
Really?
Yeah, they said they're saving it for Gamescom.
Didn't they show it last year?
They keep delaying the shit out of that game.
I'm kind of glad,
but honestly, it's an Alan Wake style game, so I'm assuming they're gonna keep delaying until it's perfect.
Which should honestly, people can disagree with me all they want, but you need to if your game isn't good, delay it. There's no reason to put. I mean,
What was like?
Don't push a like an unfinished project because people are paying full price for something that's not finished.
Clearly, Ubisoft didn't learn their fucking lesson.
Same goes to Blizzard. Cough, cough.
What did Blizzard do wrong?
Dude, WoD is a piece of shit. It's completely unfinished.
WoD?
I've heard some things about what they're potentially doing. They pushed back the movie release date.
What? There's a movie?
Well, I feel like they're spending all their time on... this turned into a Blizzard Heroes podcast. Heroes of the Storm and Overwatch. I hope that they're putting more time into that than they are into WoW, because they honestly put out a half-finished product. I mean, you're paying $60... And you're getting half of the, if anything, you're getting half of the content of previous expansions. And so that's why I agree with the whole, if you have to delay your game, however long it takes to make that game, like, perfect, do it. Because I'm pissed. I bought Warlords of Draenor. I pre-ordered it, like, a year in advance. And then they put out something half done. And it's really disappointing as a consumer. Because, I mean... Why would you pay full price for something that's not done? That's just kind of really bad.
Remind me to show you a video later.
Okay.
Just because...
That's a dragon thing.
I'll just talk about it real quick, but I won't go into detail. That apparently... Like, you know how we were talking about before that they were saying that they want to push out a new expansion every year?
Yeah.
People were saying that it would have made sense that they would release a new... expansion alongside the movie.
They could.
It comes out next year, but it got pushed back or something like that.
The movie got pushed back?
Yeah,
Well, that's fine.
Well, it's a good thing though. They're doing it as a summertime blockbuster hit movie. Cool. So it's like releasing at the beginning of summer.
What's it gonna be about?
It's about it's the original orcs versus humans conflict.
Good.
Okay. Yeah, they're going back to roots and they're gonna do a movie about orcs versus humans and how that all played out and why it all played out and all that stuff. It looks really good. It's the lead character is the main character of Vikings, if you've watched that.
Really?
Nope.
Yeah. The lead character, the main human, or no. Either the main human or the main orc is the lead character from Vikings.
Hmm.
And I've seen some, they released some shots of the orcs all done in makeup.
It looks incredible.
Freaking beautiful. If they can really make that work throughout the movie, and then, you know, make good plot works. And story, it's going to be a great movie. And I'm excited for it either way, just because I've been playing World of Warcraft since I was 10. I've been playing for
almost
9 years, almost 10 years now.
It's and like that's
insane.
I hope they
I've
make
never
it
put
work.
I've never put any amount of, or any, this is the most time I've put in any game.
I'm just excited to go to the theater when it releases, and just
how many WoW nerds,
neckbeards everywhere.
Oh, smell!
Oh, smell like PAX.
Yeah, smell like PAX. Yeah,
it's so disgusting.
It's gonna be a bigger version. When I went to the Midnight Leaf of Skyrim, and there were people that were like,
"Dude, Skyrim was so bad."
It was so fun. There were people like foam sword fighting out front of GameStop. Is hilarious.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Glorious California.
Yeah.
What game's next? What else is
about? Well, we were talking about Microsoft.
Okay, Microsoft.
So we talked about Halo, Gears of War,
No Quantum Break. I'm sure there's gonna be some random IPs they're gonna announce. I'm totally blanking on. Forza 6 is coming out.
Oh, dude.
That's right. I forgot about Forza.
They got
another one.
A lot of details. Yeah.
This one's Motorsport.
I feel like they come out all the time.
This one's the...
What was the last one? Horizon?
Yeah.
Different company.
This is the racetrack one.
Oh, that's right. They are different companies, huh?
Yeah,
Playground. I really hope Forza 6 is good then.
So this is exclusively racetracks, or...?
Yeah. But there's, like, a lot more this time to offer. Like, the details got leaked, apparently, on the Japanese Xbox.com. Yeah, whatever.
You don't mind if I change your character a bit, do you?
Okay.
But, basically...
Hardcore!
It sounds like Project Cars. Like, they're basically competing in Project Cars because that's the only other car game that's kind of, like, simulated and on the market right now.
Yeah.
So they're basically doing everything they can to get, like, oh, guess what? We're just as good, and we're on a console, blah, 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 whatever that fun stuff. I don't know. I'm excited, I guess. I don't know. Forza 5 lost its appeal because, the only reason I played because it's the only game on the Xbox when it came out. And then after I realized... I'm playing the same track over and over again, like, 4 months down the line. I was like, okay, I'm done. back to Netflix.
Well, and then after playing Forza Horizon.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You can't go back.
I can't go back to Forza 5. Forza 5 is just poop. You try and turn, and it's just like.
Yeah, definitely play differently.
I honestly can't think of anything else from Microsoft right now.
I can't think of, like. What was it? Oh. This was a while ago, and I don't even know if it's, like, valid anymore. But, like, people were saying possible Banjo-Kazooie.
I've heard that.
Oh, I heard Battletoads.
Battletoads?
I heard there's, like, a lot of, like, hardcore evidence for Battletoads being remade. Which, I don't know how well that would go.
It's like year of the remake or something?
Most people
basically
just go
every year.
So, like, who's going to buy a Battletoads?
Like, a battle? Yeah, I don't know.
Who
I
in this
no
day
interest
of age?
In a Battletoads?
Yeah, who in this day of age?
A lot of people, sadly. Yeah. People love Battletoads.
Yeah.
People love Battletoads.
I would assume most, like, Battletoads wasn't around when. I mean, it was around before we were born, so. Like.
I never played it.
Yeah, yeah. I never played it.
I feel like they're.
I don't think
maybe wrong here, but their target audience isn't really.
Like
Battletoads audience,
yeah.
You know?
I mean, there's a few, but.
The Battletoads players are all grown with kids.
Yeah.
And jobs in real lives.
Unless they can make it really.
Yeah, unless they make
appeal.
It freaking awesome.
Yeah. If they can make it appeal to the people, like the attention deficit disorder people of.
What?
20.
Connor, what the hell?
I don't know
what's wrong with you.
I don't know, it was an outfit, so I put it on.
Alright then.
I'm Dr. Spook.
You look like Batman with a pumpkin on his head.
He's the worst.
I am. He's the worst knight.
He's a pumpkin. We deserve
pumpkin pie.
Alright, so what's next?
EA, right?
Well, so there's nothing else from Microsoft?
I can't
think of anything.
Next is EA, so yes. What is next?
EA, we have a few. We have Battlefront.
There's this game called Battlefront coming out. I don't know what the hell it is. I mean, can anyone explain it to me?
It's called EA's Battlefront.
Is that really what it's called?
Yeah.
EA's Battlefront.
No,
on the cover.
Isn't it DICE's?
Aside from that really frustrating, really, really frustrating picture of the stormtrooper they had on their Instagram or whatever it was.
With the backwards eyes?
With the weird eyes?
Did we talk about this? Yeah, we did.
No,
someone explain it.
We didn't talk this to, we didn't tell this to Damon because we talked about the day after because it bugged me that.
No, we talked.
We discussed this the next day after that.
We discussed it for like 5 days straight, dude. It's unhealthy.
Yeah.
Dude. It's, okay.
No, the eye was smaller. No. Get this. I found the reference picture.
Yep. No, we found the reference picture. Don't take credit for that, you dirty whore.
I found the reference picture. I guarantee
ladies,
I'm the one that's
ladies,
you.
Ladies, you're both pretty.
Whatever, who gives a shit? Anyway,
there's a picture of sand troopers on Tatooine. The soldier on the most left has a bigger right eye than the one on the left.
They literally just took the thing over, and it looks like the exact same head and position.
All those helmets.
Someone play. I'll find it.
All the helmets are exactly
the
same.
Well, put it on
the
screen.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure that's the way it's designed. Which is really weird.
That's kind of frustrating. How do I play this game?
X to grind.
All right,
that's not X. Wait, there you go.
That is X.
And then if you push RB while grinding, you do a boost.
There's
and
no context to what we just discussed. When DICE was revealing,
he's gonna post a picture.
But someone has to explain it.
When DICE was showing off, before the trailer came out, during that whole Star Wars like fan fest, whatever it was. DICE released a picture of a stormtrooper, or a bit of a stormtrooper, every day. And it became, like, everyone's like, oh, look at this, it's so cool. These two, they're like, you know what's really frustrating? If you look at the picture, did you find the actual render, or the
I found the one that you
the
said.
Reference? On the render for Battlefront, it looks like, well, it doesn't even look like, it is. Like, the eye is.
One eye is bigger than the other.
Yeah, exactly, on the helmet.
It looks like they either. The head's turning the wrong way for where it should be, or they actually made the eyes different size for some strange reason.
It's a really weird perspective.
Very gross looking.
Yeah.
It keeps you up this
week. And if you guys see.
But we were like, wow, that's really shitty of DICE to like not pay or not
this
like actually catch
Star Wars.
That.
Look at the eyes.
Yeah, they're.
But look at theirs. Fine. I mean, that was a little different, but that's fine. That's fine. So it's gotta just be the way that something is wrong with it.
The costume designer fucked up and they didn't have enough budget to make another one.
Not enough budget.
I'm kidding.
This is Star Wars.
I'm uneducated, okay?
You know how small their budget was?
Yeah.
The first Star Wars budget was shit.
Oh, okay. Then yeah, right. I'm right. That's fact.
If you look at the Death Star, and it's not bad. It's actually really smart. All the stuff on the Death Star, all those little valves and stuff, is all for model car parts. They literally took small parts, made molds, and that's all it is. That's literally all those models are.
It's practical.
It's very practical. Instead of trying to make your own shit up, they literally just took small things and added on. But we're getting off topic again, like always.
People still do that today. For like concept artists?
Yeah, it's really smart.
Yeah. Okay, sorry about that.
Sadly, the game, if anyone who goes on the wonderful site Reddit, was, I don't know what it is right now, but was getting a lot of shit for the game because it didn't have Galactic Conquest.
Okay, wait. When Battlefront 2 was like new, I guess, me and Hunter played it every day.
I played that game unhealthily.
Yeah. Now,
with my friend CJ.
I'm going to be honest, I am a little disappointed that there's no space battles.
I don't know anything. I don't, like I said, I don't do it. I just play video games.
Honestly, okay. I really don't care.
There's no space battles. There's no Galactic Conquest, which was like,
remember Galactic Conquest that much.
It's like where...
It's like a campaign.
Yeah, it's basically like you go from planet to planet and like you do battles.
That was fun.
But yeah. See, I feel like they're going to have something like that eventually, not right away, but because it is DICE.
From that, like, the actual videos they've shown so far has been, like, hyped me. But then when after they released, like, teasers, like, video teasers, they announced, like, actual information about the game, and it was kind of underwhelming from what I remember. I don't remember, like, what specifically they announced. It was a couple months ago, but, like, I'm just hoping that they pull some magic trick out of their ass for E3.
Honestly, my thing is...
I'm still going to get it, but, like, I'm a sucker
for it. It's being made by DICE, and I love Battlefield games, so if it's going to be anything like it to an extent, for multiplayer at least, first of all, it looks beautiful.
Graphics are everything, though.
Graphics are everything, but...
Yeah, I'd take better gameplay than over...
No, don't get me wrong, I would too. But something about it just looks gorgeous, and I like the footage they showed of actual like flying in-game in like ships.
Or not in-game, but it was
in-engine's technical talk for saying
this is
potentially,
if you had a $5,000 computer, this is what you could play.
But even then, it's still gonna be I still think the game's gonna be fun.
September.
Galactic Conquest. I mean, don't get me wrong, if they had it, it'd be fun too. But at this point, I just want a Battlefront game back. And it could be good, it could be bad. But I'm going to play it regardless.
I think we need more information.
No, we do.
Yeah, we definitely
do. Because hopefully we will get more information.
In 6 days.
We will. Yeah, there's no doubt that EA is going to pull that card out.
What company was it where they had an actual big game that was like that we were expecting last year and they just talked about Sims?
Sony.
EA.
Oh, was that EA?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We were expecting Battlefront.
It's like, here's Sims for
free. Well, they did show Battlefront,
but for like
nothing to do with the game.
It wasn't all the in-studio stuff they were talking about? We went to the old filming setup, and we looked at all the models, and I'm like, what does it tell us?
They had probably just started, like...
They had for a year beforehand.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, this is the third year.
Oh, EA, Mirror's Edge, right? Am I right? Yeah.
Yes, Catalyst, or whatever. Whatever just got announced today.
Well, that's
the next
one
I want to
talk about.
Mirror's Edge Catalyst?
Okay.
It's not Mirror's Edge 2, it's called Mirror's Edge Catalyst.
DICE is also working on the next Mirror's Edge, which they've already announced, like, I think last year.
Yeah.
But today, actually, like, a few hours ago, it was just confirmed that this new Mirror's Edge is not Mirror's Edge 2. It's a reboot of Mirror's Edge as a whole, and it's called Mirror's Edge Catalyst.
Huh.
Which is a horrible name.
Reboot?
Reboot, I'm which is like...
Like, same story and shit? Or are they doing it again?
New story.
New character?
Same character.
Oh, okay.
From what I can tell. I
don't understand that logic.
Or I don't know. From what I've read, it's not a sequel.
We'll find out tomorrow for sure.
Tomorrow?
Not tomorrow.
Are you time teller?
I'm tired. Mirror's Edge Catalyst... There's nothing to really say about that because there's nothing really out, so we don't really know about that. But
it would be cool if they announced Oculus Rift support for that game, though.
Oh, that'd be so disorienting.
Imagine how sick you would get.
Oh,
yeah.
My God.
I don't know. I haven't tried it virtual reality headset yet, but I feel like if I feel like
Oh, you're not gonna throw up? Okay.
If it didn't make me like sick, I feel like that would be such a cool concept for virtual reality.
Yeah.
Or VR. Just cause like it's freaking parkour. And like although I am scared of heights, so I don't know. Maybe I would get disturbed.
But that's why you do it on
Bites Oculus or Rift. Heights? Bites.
Bites. Okay, cool.
He doesn't like cheese bites.
Mm-hmm.
Scare him.
Fuck cheeseburgers.
Cheese. Anything else for EA?
So it's
Sims 5?
Yeah!
No, Battlefield PGA.
Oh, that's right. They actually doing that?
Is that real?
That was real. They actually made that last year.
That was an incredible. Okay.
I thought it was a joke. I thought it was a joke or like a mod or something.
Totally real.
Wow.
It was for EA Golf.
Yeah.
That's terrible.
That's awesome.
We're going to see a lot of sports.
I haven't played it.
Oh, yeah, there is going to be a lot of sports.
There's going to be a lot of sports, and they're going to talk about how this game is revolutionary and how you should care about.
Yeah, do they understand that, like...
No one cares?
Yeah, I don't know if I'm just being uneducated here, but I feel like people who go to and watch E3 have no care for the sports games whatsoever.
I don't think the football fanatics that play.
Yeah, because they're all like...
I don't know.
Either the nerds who want to be jocks or the jocks who are trying to be...
Chase would watch E3 and he plays sports games. But he's not like a huge, like... I don't know if he'd watch E3.
I don't know.
He'd like go back and watch like recaps, but he wouldn't sit down and watch it. So, it is kind of dumb.
It's part of the magic.
How much more realistic can a football game get besides...
I looked up E3...
Well, a lot of it's like updating teams.
I looked up EA from 2015
really
E3.
Lame.
The first thing is hugely anticipated reboot to Mirror's Edge will make an appearance at E3 2015.
Cool.
So
hugely anticipated.
Apparently people are really stoked about it, which are
Mirror's Edge is cool.
It didn't seem like you were stoked at it when you first said it, but I mean like a recap...
It's just weird.
Like the name, or
they can make a sequel.
Well, it's not really.
I know they should make it. I don't know why they're like trying to reboot the entire franchise.
I don't know what to think.
But I mean,
of
did
it,
the last game really have that strong of a story?
No.
Exactly. So maybe.
So why does it matter?
No. Then why? Then I don't see why they would do a sequel.
Well, why reboot?
There's nothing
it?
To run off of.
Yeah, yeah, it's the same argument either way. Like,
yeah, that's true.
I don't know. I don't know how to feel
what they
about
do.
It.
I think that they can pull it off. I hope.
Well, I'm not doubting they can pull it off. I'm just saying it's just weird that they decided to go with this approach.
True.
Why not just call it Mirror's Edge 2 instead of Catalyst, which makes it sound like a mobile game? Because that's what I thought it was when I first heard it.
Oh my god.
Catalyst? Why?
Because anything of a subtitle like that would be like, I'll be like, oh, okay, well, that's clearly not a sequel to the game.
No, but dude, they're breaking
Assassin's Creed Chronicles?
Exactly. And,
is that a mobile?
Yeah, it's a mobile game, I'm pretty sure.
He just proved his point by trying to, like, disprove it.
That's why at least I'm glad that Halo 5 is called Halo 5 Guardians, not Halo Guardians. I'm just like, if it's called Guardians, I probably wouldn't buy it. I'm just kidding.
But, wow.
Yeah,
what a name.
You were so quick to say that you were kidding.
Yeah. I want to defend my title as a fanboy, okay?
You are, dude. The only one here who's read every book.
And
read every lore.
I'm... filled with literature.
And is a huge nerd.
Excuse me?
Yeah, none of us here are big nerds. Mm-hmm. We're not having a video game podcast right now.
Well, sorry.
I'm sweating my ass off.
We're talking about Halo, right? Yeah.
I can't think of anything else for EA.
There's that one game that the creators of Need for Speed were going to make. And remember, it was like people falling out of helicopters and stuff, and it was really cool.
Stuntman 2015.
That's what it looked like. And it was like, oh, you can drive an ATV into a helicopter, and it's really cool because it's realistic. And I was like, that sounds awesome. And then we never heard of it ever again.
Yeah, I don't know.
Also, I just thought of something else that I'm surprised you didn't think of, well, I just saw, for goddamn EA, Mass Effect 4. Yeah, I knew that would get you going again.
That's EA?
Yeah. I was reading.
I wrote that down.
I was reading. It says Mass Effect 4 and Star Wars Battlefront are likely to be put in appearance during the keynote, as well as FIFA, Madden, Dragon Age, and Battlefield.
Dragon Age? I don't really care about Dragon Age. Mass Effect's more in my books than Dragon Age. I bought Inquisition, never touched it.
I didn't play it at all. I returned it for GTA 5.
Good choice.
Yeah.
Not saying Dragon Age is a bad game.
No, I just...
It's too big.
Yeah. It didn't really capture me like I wanted it to.
So, I mean, I don't think there's anything else left for
Mass Effect 4.
What about...
Oh, my God.
Have they released anything about it?
No, that's why I wanted...
Didn't stuff get leaked?
Supposedly. But, like...
Leaks can always be
supposedly. Yeah, but, like, apparently this is the same way Dragon Age Inquisition got leaked, so... Maybe.
How'd the Dragon Age Inquisition leak go?
Through a survey. an online survey, and the same thing for Mass Effect 4 just happened. So
people what, like, the, what was the survey like? Would you be interested in Mass Effect 4
if it had this and this and that? Or would you be interested if it did this and this and this? Yeah. And
so people, that's not even a leak. That's like a, hey, this is coming. What do we want in it?
Yeah, but you're under a strict NDA. Not talk about it. So yeah,
and it people is a talk leak. About it.
Yeah,
here we are. Yeah.
Oh, so it was like a survey to like VIPs
and,
only.
Yeah, and it's funny how it's like, it's funny that because usually when someone leaks something, they leave, they want to take credit for it. And this time, when this person leaked it, they actually removed their Reddit account and made a throwaway and all that stuff, and like hid their tracks. Yeah, that's like they good. Covered their tracks.
So that,
which means
that it's means probably it's probably real. Legit.
So basically,
or the they're game, really genius.
This game probably takes trolling. Place like 200 years in the future, past Mass Effect 3, just to avoid the horrendous 3 ending. and it takes place in a different galaxy. Everything that we talked about so far, I was like, I need more information.
Yeah,
basically,
I need more information. Well, we're gonna get all this.
Well, that's what E3 is about, though.
Yeah. Well, this is it's a speculation.
Well, and this is mainly to get other people's opinions on what they think of the game too. So
honestly, I think the companies themselves tend to like they probably leak some stuff too.
No, yeah. News. Oh, if House of Cards taught me anything, leaks happen on purpose.
Dude,
yeah,
really? This got leaked. Oh, damn it!
It creates news buzz. For them. Yeah. You know?
Yeah, it creates excitement, hype.
Like I wouldn't be talking about like
I wouldn't be surprised if they had one guy in charge of just hyping the game.
Well, no, I remember it's not with like leaking, but I think what was it, GTA or what game was it? They actually paid for bad publicity.
Yeah, it was GTA.
Yeah, it was GTA.
That's how they got popular.
They paid for bad publicity, and it gets people on like controversy. They're like, oh shit, this game's bad.
Well, it's like,
but we gotta try it.
It's funny because we were talking about that the other day when we were filming. Well, before we filmed Mortal Kombat, how we're talking about hatred.
Hatred versus versus GTA.
Well, it's like hatred's like, it's like
much more popular than it should be just because of the controversy.
Yeah, and
it is rated adult only, which isn't very common for a lot of games.
Is that how many adult only games are there? I'm sure there's a lot, but
they don't sell them.
I'm pretty sure the Ron Jeremy game is the only one that's
you can't like Microsoft.
Oh, fuck yeah, there is.
Microsoft, Sony, like none of them sell anything that's rated anything UA. Above mature.
Yeah.
And even when this got announced, like they pulled it from Steam for a little while, and then it went back up.
I don't think I wonder if it's because they don't want mature things on their platforms, or they know that it's gonna be like it's not gonna sell.
Maybe both.
Yeah, well, I feel like a UA title, you never hear about them, so they don't.
Yeah,
this is the first one I've ever heard about. Honestly,
I wonder if they're allowed to have a marketing campaign.
Probably not.
Are they legally allowed to have like commercials and stuff?
Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
Wait, what?
AO. It might have got AO after the Hot Coffee Month came out.
I think because that's the main picture that shows right there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pixels having.
Oh my god! Yeah, that's a.
Yeah, so stuff like that.
Stuff like that. Yeah. There's one literally called the Playboy Mansion.
But like you know,
anime stuff.
Dude, literally the next these have all been anime.
We're going to Ubisoft. Who is excited for Ubisoft games? The only Ubisoft games I'm excited for are the Tom Clancy ones, and that's pretty much it.
There's more. Out on Ubisoft. There's more.
What?
I just saw them and I gotta go back.
No, I know there's more.
I'm excited for the Siege. Like Siege looks amazing.
Clancy.
What we saw last week, or what we saw last year at E3, got me so hyped. And the Division. Yes,
I'm so excited for Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
Shut your mouth.
Do we want to talk about that?
How terrible it's gonna be, probably.
I don't know if it's going to be terrible.
I just don't think anyone's going to buy it.
Assassin's Creed,
they've run their course, honestly.
They need to take a break for like 5 years and then come out with like a really solid game and be like, hey guys, we're sorry.
They should switch it off with Watch Dogs.
Use
the team.
Yeah, well, actually,
I'm not saying rumors include
a Watch Dogs sequel.
That's not a negative thing.
Okay.
They should swap. Like,
I'm all for that. And I think I've said it on video before, but like I really enjoyed Watch Dogs, even though I know a lot of people didn't like it. It wasn't as cool as like
they seemed kind of the boring videos. To me.
I enjoyed it so much. I don't know, maybe I'm just like dumb or something, but like I think the idea for it was just enough for me to get really into it.
Yeah, it's
like the idea of like that vigilante style, like hacker
cyber vigilante.
I think. And especially for, like, the first game, for an IP, I thought it was decent.
Come on, bitch.
If they did, like, a second game that was really polished...
Fix the mistakes they did before.
Yeah, like, made it... I mean, it was... The hacking stuff was kind of underwhelming.
New IPs are never always perfect. I mean,
I thought it was pretty good for a first game in new IP. I'd be super stoked for a sequel. I'd give it a shot. But yeah, I'd be all for them switching Assassin's Creed with Watch Dogs because they're kind of similar.
They're very similar. From what
I played, they're very actually most Ubisoft games are pretty similar.
You know what's like? You know what it would do too? It would also make the development team a little more inspired because then like you get to focus on something else for a while, and then you go back to Assassin's Creed, and they have always fresh new ideas for the game.
Yeah,
let the ideas build up for a few years, and then put them all into one great freaking new game.
Well, also,
those games are Frankenstein monsters. You know,
Ubisoft. Like, it also says the publisher say that there will be a quote a few big surprises. End quote.
What could they surprise us with?
Ubisoft? I don't...
New IPs, like, I
can't think of any IPs that Ubisoft
would give us. That's what I'm saying. Either new IPs or talk of a Watch Dogs sequel, like I just said. But I don't know if that would really be...
Yeah, that's not a big shocker.
Wait, which one?
Yeah, seriously, for a company like that?
Which publisher is The Division?
Ubisoft.
It is
Ubisoft?
I am so excited. Like, that... If that is... Like,
I really hope that game turns out to be even like
half as good as that first gameplay trailer they gave us. No, it has to be. It has to be as good.
It has to be as good.
If it's as good as that first gameplay trailer they gave us,
they're gonna watch this video.
That is gonna be an amazing game.
They're gonna watch our video.
But at the same time, like that was 2 years ago.
Yeah,
they released that.
They didn't work really 2 years ago.
The good news is they keep fucking delaying it.
Yes, I'm glad. I think they know the potential. That
either it's not. Well, they could just not be working.
That's a good possibility.
Yeah, always gotta see the downside too, though.
No, like honestly, there's no reason for any of us to be excited for a Ubisoft game right now.
That's true.
They've proved this past year that they do not deserve the hype.
Then let's skip Ubisoft and move right on to Sony.
No, I don't have to skip them. Watch Dogs, Assassin's Creed. I'm sure there's one game I'm missing right now. Oh, The Crew.
Oh, yeah.
It looked cool.
It looked awesome.
But the minute I drove in-game for the demo, I wanted to throw up.
It had Troy Baker in it.
It had him and, what's-his-face?
His other love brother from...
I don't want to play this anymore.
The guy...
I'm not doing anything.
His brother in Infamous.
Yeah, play a different game.
Switch it off.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
They were ending, huh?
And they were brothers in The Crew.
Hey, Ryan playing Elders.
I think that... I just want to talk about The Division for a little bit because it looks both The Division and Siege.
What's our runtime at?
For like an hour.
Also, we missed Tomb Raider for Microsoft.
We still have Sony.
Oh, yeah. That's not.
I forgot about it. Tomb Raider.
Tomb Raider's cool, but I haven't played the first one.
We'll skip it.
So I don't know.
Four poly person.
I played the games all the time as a kid on PlayStation 1, but that has nothing to do with the new stuff. So, what else? You want to talk about something real quick, Damon?
I want to talk about The Division and Siege.
Yeah, Siege looks beautiful.
They both look really good.
Play Jackbox, honestly.
No,
you can't. That's
too much concentration.
Because, I mean, the whole, your friend comes in on his iPad as a drone and, like, scouts the area for you.
Yeah.
If they pull that off, that's like... I don't know. Has it been done any game?
Yeah. Well, no, not the drone thing, but like
direct. Like you're actually playing in the world on an iPad.
There've been a few. What was it? Well, Battlefield, like it's not like your character, but you can play.
Oh yeah.
On your iPad as a commander, so you can call down like airstrikes. You can drop. I don't remember what it was, but like you help your team. Without like directly being on the battlefield, you're a commander that watches the map. And you do it from your iPad, or I think it's just iPad, or on PC. You could do it on your computer too. But like
smart glass, whatever.
Yeah, that's what it was. It was because the Xbox just came out, and I mean, PlayStation also has something similar.
Well, my stick.
But the idea, like when they first came out, they had this like you have smart glass where you can. For example, like on you can use stuff on your phone, like with Destiny, or I don't remember what they used.
I don't know. Basically.
Or no, okay, Watch Dogs. Watch Dogs had it. Like on my phone, I could play with other people where I'm hacking into their game, and they're trying to escape me and stuff like that. But as of like lately, I haven't seen any games doing the smart glass stuff anymore.
If, yeah, because if I mean, if they can really make that, because like what I saw in the trailer was that they're actually in the world. You can see them, and they're taking direct part in the battle and what's going on, but they're, you know, they're from a remote location. I think that's really cool.
Yeah.
Like, it's not just something small. It's actually like a big, like, he came in, I don't remember if you guys remember, he came in on the drone, and he, like, pinpointed all, and, like, basically gave him x-ray vision of everybody, and then, like, I don't know, I think he, like, threw a grenade at one of them to, like, to pull him out of cover or something like that.
It was a concussion grenade.
Yeah, it was like a little concussion grenade. Like, that's freaking cool.
It was awesome. Stuff and but at the same time, like, they're going to have to balance the game. So how much of that do you think would be, like, them just showing it off?
I don't think there's any PvP.
There will be.
Well, they've announced it's going to be, like, kind of, like, not an MMO, but, like, there's going to be other people in the world.
Yes.
You're not just going to be playing a single
player.
It's
like Destiny. Your own.
Yeah.
From what I remember them talking about, and it's been a while, but, like the idea was that, like, if there's another player that you run into, there's a chance, like, they can help you out.
Yeah.
Or they can turn on you and try to take your resources or something. Just
fucking, like, that's going to suck.
Yeah, it's going to be scary.
Imagine if you got a game where everyone that joined and helped each other and you made, like, the world perfect.
Yeah.
But it would never happen because there's always that one asshole.
Well, that's what they try to do in, like, DayZ and stuff.
That's why I don't like those games. And it just turns into
everyone just kills each other.
Yeah.
But what if, okay, imagine a scenario like all the Badgers are playing or something. So we're like a group of five.
Yeah, we're a group of survivors or whatever.
You know? Punch would even get on his Xbox
if people, if people would decide to, like, try and be nice to us or try and take us on, I feel like that would be awesome.
That's cool. Yeah, we have companions, but if you're a single person running around in that world, I feel like it's going to be a lot the same with DayZ.
You're just going to get shot.
You're just going to get ganked by, you know, people with more equipment or people at a higher level if they have that kind of system.
But at the same time, I think they're going to try and balance it somehow.
I don't think the
game we're going to get is going
to
be what we saw.
They need
saw.
To give some form of true incentive to work.
Especially, I think the tech, like the helicopter stuff, I think that's campaign only, honestly.
But, I mean, they were co-oping.
Yeah, co-op and campaign.
Yeah.
Because they had like, set names, like it was, like, a campaign, like they were actually doing something. I think there is going to be, like, a PvP, like you said, like an open-world PvP where it's just, like, come try to survive.
Yeah.
Which would be, I mean, it'd be cool if it was just literally guns and
separate
groups.
Those.
You just have your own, custom character and you have your campaign. That's all it is, really.
I think the two are actually intertwined.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure the two are intertwined.
That would be hard to do.
Which is why it's taken such a long time.
Yeah, but if they pull it off and it comes out good, that would be the first good game in the world.
Intertwining open world PvP with an actual campaign and stuff. Without turning it too much into a World of Warcraft kind of thing where you have quests and then you have, you know, designated PvP areas. That's something new. Like, that's something no one's really done.
Well, it's actually,
to my knowledge.
Like, it's the first time I've heard of a high budget DayZ actually being made.
That's true.
And the best part, no zombies. They confirmed no zombies.
Oh, good. So then what actually happened to the city? It seemed very zombie-like.
It just got infected and died. That's probably
true. I think it's either infected and died, or it was almost like the Great Depression, where things just turned to shit, economy went down, and people started dying. Yeah, which is kind of it's different. Honestly, the zombie fad needs to end.
Yeah,
the whole zombie or apocalypse. I mean, I shouldn't say apocalyptic because Fallout's coming out, but that's not really like a zombie game. It's just like
there are zombies in it.
There's zombies, though. But it's literally just like hell happened.
It's not like Rise from the Dead. It's like they got mutated by nuclear waste or nuclear fallout.
Mm-hmm. Although there is people that probably risen from the dead. But anyway.
Fallout.
I think we're done with Ubisoft. We can move on to Sony.
Well, Rainbow Six Siege.
Oh, shit, yeah. I keep forgetting about
Siege.
That. Is there really anything to talk about it, though?
Besides the fact that it looks really fun.
Well,
it does look really fun.
It's going to be really competitive.
Well,
that's good. I like competitive. Like,
it seems very, like, strategy-based. Like, not just strategy, but, like, good. Like, you need a good team that can communicate, I guess.
It's going to be more along the lines of, like, a... It's going to be, like, a console Counter-Strike. Well, I mean, there's a console Counter-Strike, isn't there?
Counter-Strike.
But it's going to be, like, that kind of thing, where it's, like, yes, it's a team-versus-team first-person shooter, but you can't just run around and gun people down. You really have to... You know, plan and enter. Like, you have to have entry strategies. You have to have exit strategies. Right. From what I've seen, like, it looks so good because it's a true competitive. if they do it right,
you fucked up immediately. First move, you killed your own teammate.
Good job, eh?
If they pull it off, it's gonna be like it's gonna be a really that could be a really cool competitive thing where I could see actual like teams and like oh I don't know maybe even to the point where it becomes like an MLG kind of thing.
I definitely see that becoming
that'd like, be cool MLG, like
yeah
like C9 there's like a Cloud9 team that plays the Siege mm-hmm. and just like they all communicate really well and it's like straight up military ops.
Did you
that'd be cool.
Go back to Halo 5. Did you ever play that game type they showed off in the beta? The one that's like one life five SMG starts only.
Ooh,
for Halo 5.
Fun. That sounds really fun.
It's fast paced, no shields. So basically, so you turn around the corner, and you die, and you're like, fuck.
So that's really.
I don't think I've played that.
That's very Counter-Strike.
It was super. Yeah, it was exactly like Counter Strike. No bombs though. That's all. What's Hunter's?
Hey.
Hunter's password is password.
Wait, did you sign in already?
No, you have.
Just choose one.
Or you can probably sign in as me.
Or sign in as me.
I have to do this.
You're signed in as you. I can just sign in as Evan.
Okay.
So I was doing that. I was still trying to do, I think. I have to just sign in as you.
Boo. All right. What are we talking about? I think
we've talked about Ubisoft.
I just like the fact that the strategy based kind of games instead
they're
of
I hope this is a strong year or at least all these like there's more strategy games coming out and if they actually like
Jesus.
Work I miss them like,
oh my god.
Spike
thank you condenser Mike.
Yeah I guess what I feel like games have become this is a bold statement, and I might get hated for this, but I feel like games have become very casual. I mean, I know they're supposed to be, but like those games that really require a lot of, like, time and thought.
What do I do?
That's exactly what I just complained about with Destiny last night. I was like, this game is too casual.
Yeah.
Because, like, I can be doing really good for my team and just get immediately die from a super.
Get immediately die?
Just, like... Like, for no apparent reason. Like, I'll be hiding around a corner and somebody will get me.
Yeah.
Like, there's too many things out of my reach.
High skill cap games is what we need. We need more high skill cap games.
Was that in your pocket?
Yep.
Probably so warm.
Together and warm.
Something all together.
Like the rest of us right now.
I wonder what that would look like if we melted it.
It would just like turn into sugar. Okay.
No.
Okay, well,
on to Sony.
I don't know.
None
of us
Sony.
Play Sony games.
Avery and I own a PlayStation 4. And
but,
that's about the extent
but
of it.
I'm looking at this thing right here, and I'm looking at what Sony is going to be announcing.
Dark
and it says, there's a possibility of some talk of games including Fallout 4, Destiny, Star Wars Battlefront, Bloodborne, The Witness, and No Man's Sky. Which No Man's Sky...
No Man's Sky looked cool.
Is that really pretty one where it's more like just for room?
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about it yet. I'm not going
to... There's multiple planets to explore.
I mean, I'm not going to be like, dude, this is the best game ever, but it's just going to be like, okay.
That's interesting.
Poor man's Star... I think it's a poor man's Star Citizen.
No, it is, but I'm... it's really colorful. It's more simplistic colorful, so I'm going to try it.
More of a cartoon look, I think. All
right, how do they... I could see them doing a Bloodborne expansion.
The problem with...
Or big, like, DLC.
No, that'll definitely be a thing. Going back to No Man's Sky, it's that it's not multiplayer. It's only single player.
Yeah. It's purely, like, exploration-based.
Yeah.
And, like...
That's cool. I like exploration games.
Yeah, but how... Like, if you had friends... If you had friends...
Damon!
Oh, look at that spike. There's like seven of them.
Avery's crying inside right now.
Your poor heart.
Damon.
Your poor... Ah!
Look at that spike!
So metal.
Okay, but I mean, honestly, other games, I mean, like... No Man's...
Destiny will make an appearance there.
Destiny is just...
Okay, big one's gonna be Uncharted. Oh, here's
4?
Uncharted 4.
Or the remakes. Or the reboots.
That says Uncharted 4.
Definitely
well, no.
Uncharted 4.
With the delay of Uncharted 4, all eyes will be on Sony at its press conference on the 15th of June to see what the company has up its sleeve in the way of exclusive content this side of Christmas. So...
What do they have coming out this Christmas?
Besides Uncharted?
Yeah.
I've been waiting for freaking Kingdom Hearts.
That's not coming out until after 15 comes out.
What?
That's not coming out until after 15 comes out. Final Fantasy, sorry.
Why? But I just want some kind of like...
Because that's what they said.
this one not doing well.
But what is it for selecting and why?
I miss Kingdom Hearts, man.
I thought it was X. It's like
that in Battlefront or Battlefront.
It's been what, like 8 years since like Kingdom Hearts 2?
Yeah.
No, it's been 10.
10?
Came out in 2004.
I guess it was 8 years, 2 years ago when they announced it. Or said they started working on it.
And it's been 10 years since Battlefront 2 and 10 years since Kingdom Hearts 2.
Like I mean it would be nice, but I'm not expecting like a release date or anything. I just wanna see it.
What's it happening?
I just wanna see
progress.
Something, yeah. I would be so happy if I can see anything.
On what
especially
again?
Like
Kingdom Hearts.
Now Disney owns the rights to like Marvel, and Star Wars now.
You think they'll act on it?
Oh,
I can see them doing something Star Wars.
I didn't even connect that.
Not like any main character, like maybe like some of the side characters, like what's who was that chick? The octopus looking chick? Or not octopus.
Ursula?
The Draenei chick? I don't know.
From Star Wars?
Yeah. Not from the movies, but like just in the I just remember from the cartoon. I didn't even do anything. I can't go anything.
What?
Go anywhere. I don't know. I can see them doing like Jedi, but not like Obi-Wan or Yoda or someone.
But then again, they did main characters from a lot of other franchises. Well, I mean, Disney. All Disney. But like, yeah.
Well, they're all Disney now, but
I can't see them doing like Marvel.
That'd be
Watch
really
me
weird.
Be like completely wrong, and they do the other
Iron but, Man.
Yeah, I can't see them doing like any main Marvel stuff right now, but I could see them like.
You don't have an answer this time.
Because like, imagine a lightsaber Keyblade.
Oh,
that's something they could.
I
do.
I mean, they already have the you know the. Psh, the hill.
Yeah, that one.
They just put that at the top. There you go, lightsaber Keyblade.
I don't know how they could do it, but I could see it like.
Did you see that video of the...
I just wanted to have
They went through all the Star Wars footage and added, like, random lightsaber parts to it.
The Swiss Army knife one?
Like. Yeah. One of them had, like a swirl around it. It was funny.
Square Enix doesn't have no
Square
purpose,
Enix
right?
has already confirmed that it will be showing off gameplay of, how do you pronounce that? That Duex?
Deus Ex Machina?
Deus Ex, there you go. I never remember how to pronounce that shit.
Bless you.
We want to see more news about Kingdom Hearts 3 and Final Fantasy 28,000, whatever the hell, whatever number that is.
Funny story, in class, I thought it was pronounced Deus Ex Machina, and everybody thought I said Deus Ex Machina.
I'm blue, right?
And everybody in class looked at me like I was insane, and my teacher was like, what did you just say? And I said Deus Ex Machina, and she's like, no. And then she's like, correct answer is Deus Ex, or what, Deus Ex Machina? And I was like, that's what I said, and she's like, no, it's not. She shut me down, like, really hard.
You Latin illiterates.
Yeah, I know.
What else?
Bloody Knuckles?
Yeah, that's it.
Done? We have Destiny.
That was really...
I don't know. I'm never really excited for Sony's conferences.
They're usually
just really boring. Am I the only one that feels like that?
Wait, last year's was underwhelming.
Yeah.
I feel like the year before was really, really good.
The year before that was really good because the entire time they bashed on Microsoft.
But it wasn't like directly like I don't know. It was like, more just they got lucky.
They just
happened to have better specs, and that they announced theirs after
under
Xbox had their little
meltdown.
Yeah.
Under the Sony tab, it's talking about Project Morpheus, which
I forgot about that.
I think
hype died after Vive got announced.
Yeah, I'm set on Vive, honestly.
Also, oh, that's a bomb.
With the Steam? No.
That's
the Valve's.
Valve's and
console?
HTC.
Yeah.
No, it's their VR headset.
But also, it was just saying, it talks about how Xbox just released the new Xbox One, or newer, kind of, or announced it.
What?
It says right there.
The 1 terabyte.
Yeah, 1 terabyte, and it says,
I feel like that's
it's not new.
It's just different, but it's just other possibilities include a slimmer PS4 or a new model with 1 terabyte, like the new Xbox One.
I heard that's actually happening.
I don't know if they'll do slimmer yet.
That'd be really annoying if they wasted game time with more console stuff.
You know what they're gonna talk about all their social media again.
No. Yeah, that's actually really funny because they did it last year.
That's the thing that everyone gave Microsoft shit for the year before. They're like, Sony didn't do anything. They talked about games. And the next year, all their shit was about that and that stupid ass military side scrolling game that was really depressing.
Valiant Hearts.
Yeah, Valiant Hearts.
That's definitely Ubisoft.
That's yeah, all, but Sony talked about that.
Mm-mm. They talked about that superhero show they were doing, a TV show.
Oh. Why would they talk about a TV show at an E3 conference?
Because they're stupid as shit.
Because they needed to advertise it. What was it?
I forgot the name. Radiant? Powers.
Powers. But, like, yeah, last year Sony did that, and then their, what was their big game? Little Big Planet? Was that it?
Which they announced Bloodborne? On the spot? Bloodborne. Bloodborne was definitely the biggest game there. Uncharted 4 got a trailer.
Really nice looking trailer.
Which wasn't a representation of the real graphics.
But it's still, it was hype worthy at the time, but even though I've never played Uncharted.
I'm glad they're making the remake, because I'll never touch my PS3 again.
Uncharted?
Yeah. Well, not the remake. I guess it's a remake. It is a remake, I guess. Or a remaster. There you go. They're doing 1, 2, and 3.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, after that, Sony really has nothing.
What just happened?
Wow.
That was effective.
It's pretty well done.
So they really talked about... there's nothing else to really talk about for Sony. Next is Nintendo. Nothing I can think about for Sony. Sony's kind of dead.
Nintendo has more.
Well, okay. Here's the thing. I was really hyped for Nintendo this year. Because last year they... I think it was last year they debuted or like announced the new Legend of Zelda. The open world Legend of Zelda.
Mm.
Going back to their original roots where it's like... it's not linear. You kind of have to rely on exploring and then kind of... No one kind of scooting you like where which dungeon to go next to or stuff like that. Like they did in Link to the Past, I think.
You should kill yourself.
Don't do it.
But, so yeah, they announced that last year. And they've said that they're not going to be showing it at all this year.
Damn it. My last Zelda game was Twilight Princess.
Never, I think I played one Zelda game in that.
That was an amazing game.
Good one. I never played Zelda, really, actually.
Ran upstairs probably... I probably lost like 30 pounds playing that game.
Why?
Super exaggeration. I ran up and down my stairs like 50 times to go to the computer for walkthroughs. I got stuck beyond a, like... What the hell? Oh, it just committed suicide. Right? That game gave me so much trouble because I was kind of young when I played it, and so I was like, I don't know what to do here, especially in like the dungeons and temples and shit.
Squeak your demon.
I was sorry about Twilight Princess.
I have demon.
I don't remember how old I was, but I was playing on the Wii, like with freaking motion controls and stuff.
Yeah, so was I.
But there was that. Do you remember? There was. I feel like in every Zelda game. The water temples
are always retardedly hard.
From
the sun.
I was stuck on the water temple, right? And what happened, like, with that game is when you save and, like, turn off, you keep your progress, but it, like, starts you at the beginning of the dungeon. And it's, like, any doors you opened are closed again and stuff like that. So you save your progress, but, like, you have to do a lot of it over. So... I was stuck and I left my Wii on overnight so I can like finish it the next day, right?
Oh god.
Well,
is that a bird?
Damn. I can't wait for it to smell it. Well, my mom had saw I turned the Wii or I left the Wii on, I turned the TV off.
Oh no.
My mom saw after I went to bed, she saw that the Wii was still on. And so, and it had a little green light on the front, you know, where to press exactly, and then it turns straight off. Well, she turned it off, and little Avery woke up the next morning.
A broken heart.
Saw that the game was turned off, and I never beat that damn game.
You just stopped there.
Freaking water temple. Yeah, I was like, I'm not doing all that again.
Yeah, the water temple took me a good long while.
So, I might actually go through and play through it again.
I won't.
On my computer.
Dude, since when did nerds get so hard to fucking open, dude?
I know you. Do any of you guys really play like, Pokemon?
I play Pokemon?
Yeah, Pokemon. Besides, like, Zeta and Omicron?
I honestly haven't touched that since I told Damon about it.
They'll probably announce their new. Well,
guy made his own game and it's beautiful.
Pokemon Mystery Dungeon. I don't know if they'll have like a new or like another main Pokemon game or what.
You say hentai?
Hentai
Pokemon game.
They have Ash Yoshi's Woolly World.
Gotta catch them all.
I see.
Yoshi's Woolly World.
Star Fox.
New Nintendogs, right?
Nintendo.
Oh my god.
Is that for real? Although, they'll probably be Star Fox.
No, I'm sure.
There will be. They hinted at it a lot last year.
Yeah.
Like, there was a part where, Miyamoto?
I remember this video, yeah.
He was like, they were talking about Mario Maker at the time. And he was, like, talking about, like, their future projects. And he's, like, obviously playing Star Fox on his monitor, but it's, like, blurred out. But you can tell it's Star Fox because it's, like, you know, you have a ship in the middle and they're shooting at oncoming stuff and he's doing barrel rolls and stuff.
Yeah.
But they blurred it out. Right. It's supposed to be, like, a tease. So they'll probably talk about that this year. Because if they don't have Legend of Zelda, I don't know what their big game's supposed to be. This is a hard game to play and, like,
not think.
Talk over. Because either you just talk and not play, or...
Or you play and not talk.
You play and die.
Almost went on that cat hair
ridden. The Game of Thrones.
This game... Dude, this is like the worst map ever. Look at this. Why won't they put me over here? And when did they get all that water right there? Mm-hmm. Oh, you did that, you butthole.
Are any of you guys, like, big Nintendo fans?
Sure.
Kinda.
Sure.
I like Smash Brothers.
Yeah, that's what the only game I play.
Lucas is coming out soon, and they'll probably announce new characters.
Snake.
There's rumors of Ryu from Street Fighter.
Oh, that'd be cool.
But how?
But he already has a fighting game.
Yeah.
So does
Little Mac.
Yeah.
But not recently.
Yeah. Yeah. Punch out on the Wii. Oh, he's had recent games. But he was initially, like, way back when. But
They just weren't big.
You think Street Fighter would keep close to their characters? Because since they're making Street Fighter 5.
I don't know. It could be, like, a promo thing. Like, in Melee, they added Roy. I think Roy.
Oh, shit.
They added Roy to, like, because Fire Emblem was coming out in Japan.
Oh.
And then that's what brought Fire Emblem to the North American market. Or the Western market, I guess. No, not Western. Whatever. Basically, Fire Emblem wasn't a thing until Melee, and everyone's like, we love Roy.
So then the game
and Marth, and then so they started bringing it to North America.
That's cool.
Not that, like, we obviously have Street Fighter here, but it could be, like,
there's a... There's dig down. Can I just dig sideways?
Could be, like, a kind of like a... There's a new one coming out soon or something?
I don't know if there's a new one coming out, but... Okay, before we end, I guess let's just go through and say what we're most excited for or looking forward to.
Just a recap.
Or, like, just what each person...
I think all of us could have the same answer.
Alright. What are you most excited for?
Fallout 4, honestly, even though it was just announced. Fallout 4 and Halo are probably my two most anticipated games.
Yeah.
I keep looking over here.
Pick two.
Two?
Yeah, pick two.
Great.
Most of us are probably going to say Fallout.
I'm going to... Just keep in mind, I agree with you. I'm also excited for the tactical, the new, like, I hope they can integrate tactical squad play into the new Halo 5 well. And then the other one I'm looking forward to the most, I guess, I'm torn between the Tom Clancy games, because those show so much promise, and that's right up my alley of the kind of games I like to play, you know, higher skill cap kind of games, like, that require a lot of thought and strategy. So yeah, I guess I'm gonna go with the squad and Halo.
Those are big words for you. Squad and strategy?
Shut up.
What about you?
Oh, me? You skipped yourself.
Well, I can't be like...
Best for life.
What does Best Avery want?
Avery, what are you...
Avery's like, I want Nintendo and bananas.
Bananas the game.
Is so good.
God damn it, Fallout 4 and Halo 5.
I'm honestly the most excited for those, but I didn't want to say that, so I touched on something else.
That's honestly all I care about.
Okay, fine, go 3 and 4. What's your third and
Mass
fourth?
Effect,
okay.
Third, Mass Effect 4, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm excited for that.
The 4s and 5s, man, that's all I gotta go for.
The 4s and 5?
Yeah. But
now, Abudu Dennis, what are you excited for?
Fallout 4.
Kingdom Hearts 3.
Nintendogs. 4.
I mean, 10. I guess number 2 would be Kingdom Hearts, even though it's probably not coming. Oh, I know it's not coming out, but that's probably what I'm looking forward to if they show anything.
Really?
I guess I'm kind of excited for Battlefront.
Wait,
I'm like,
I'm excited cautiously for all of it.
I'm excited for Battlefront, but now you guys are gonna be like dehyped for it again.
Well, I'm
why?
I'm just cautiously.
I really had that. I was like, no, it's super good. I'm like, okay.
I didn't say anything.
I'm still stoked for it, but not as much as I was.
I'll still probably buy it, but like I won't be happy about it.
Battlefront was like almost at the top for me, and then Fallout 4 was like announced. I'm just like, nothing else matters.
I'll gladly give you my money, but
also, I'm not gonna like it. If it's gonna be good, The Division.
Yes.
On my at least top
out.
5.
That's not coming
it's
out.
It's not coming out, but it may be like shown more.
2016. I guarantee Mass Effect 4 will have a 20. I saw a leak today. Or not a leak, but a rumor that it's 2016 March. Which is a lot earlier than 2017.
That's fast.
Yeah. But they've been working on it since Mass Effect 3.
Oh, wow.
So that's like...
Oh, wow.
4-5 years?
They've been working on
what? Mass Effect 4 since 3.
Doesn't that mean the first half of their development was all pre-next gen?
When did Mass Effect 3 come out? 2012? Probably?
I think all I know is like
we're gonna go over, but like, hold on. I think it's 2012. That gives probably 1 year prior. So EA knew that next gen consoles were coming out because assuming Microsoft and Sony would tell them.
I feel like it'd be hard to develop a game when you don't know what's gonna be the next.
2012.
That's the problem with all the current gen games that we have now is that they have no idea what the specs were gonna be. So at least this is coming out 2 years, 3 years prior to the consoles coming out. Either way,
should we do a wild card, or like, if we're gonna do a post one, should we do like a beforehand what we think could be like a surprise or like something that we're not expecting that they could announce? And see if any of us are right.
Let's see. Honestly, Battletoads is probably the most surprise thing. No. Microsoft announces Nintendogs 4D. With the Kinect.
4D?
With the Kinect integration.
Microsoft.
Yeah. Yeah. You can pet the dogs in reality. You'll be like, the biggest feature is you can put your hands out, you can rough the dog, and the dog's fur on the screen will get all like...
You can rough the dog?
Yeah.
Woof-woof.
Rough up the dog.
I'd like to see, as a wild card, Infamous.
The third son?
Third son.
The first
son. Because... I don't know. I mean, Infamous Son or Second Son was really good, in my opinion. It was short, but like, I'm a sucker for bad games. Apparently,
you know what I want my wild card to be?
What?
Last of Us reissue. It has to happen, guys. I mean,
the remaster.
We just remastered an already remastered
just
game.
Just what we need.
More money.
Mm-hmm. More facial follicles on Joel.
Honestly, no one's gonna agree with me, but I want to see. Because I don't even know if it's going to be it there, but...
I'm going to say no matter what. He's
like, I know you are. I think everyone's going to say no, but because it holds a special place in my heart, I'd like to see something of a like Rock Band. No one's going to agree with me.
It's going to be there.
They'll probably see
it. There's no way
it's not going to
be
there.
It's not going to be there? Okay, never mind then.
We skipped over
it. I'm stoked for Rock Band.
We talked about this before our podcast, and we said we're going to wait till we did the podcast to discuss it, but we never discussed it.
Okay, which one do you think is going to win E3? Rock Band or Guitar Hero?
Rock Band.
Because they're not having new instruments.
All right, so I thought of my surprise that I want to see. Something I've wanted for a long, long time. Skate 4.
You hit it.
I want that so bad.
I think we're done.
If EA did a Skate 4, honestly,
but
Fallout 4 wouldn't matter anymore.
That's plausible because there's
fours,
that Tony Hawk game.
The fours.
There's that Tony Hawk game coming out.
Yeah, no, they definitely.
Or that's a different thing. I was gonna say we could see maybe. Maybe some of that Half-Life 3 maybe.
No, that's
but that's not that.
That's never gonna happen.
Shut
stop
up.
Making
stop.
Stop trying to make Half-Life 3 happen.
There's logistical reasons for why that's never gonna happen.
Why?
Just remembered.
Because Valve cannot make any more money off of
it. The company that made Skate is no longer. A company. Well, then get a new company on it, because goddamn, those games are amazing.
Microsoft's rumored to announce
a new... If not a Skate, something along those lines, because those games were
great.
But it can't be a normal Skate game. It has to be glitchy as hell.
No, yeah.
Oh,
it
true.
It has some bugs. That's what made the game so good.
I like the realistic
bugginess.
Skate game until you got into, like, the bugginess.
Until you hit a trash can and everything just goes straight up in the air.
They tried.
Goat Simulator.
They tried to be realistic, but the thing is, with realistic engines, you have a lot of room for mistakes.
Errors.
Goat Skate
Simulator. Hilarious mistakes.
But honestly, yes, I
Goat
actually...
Goat Simulator.
I'm glad you said that.
Skate Edition.
Yeah. I'm taking that from you and using that as my wild card, too, because
I
love that as
I think
card.
We all just changed it to our wild card.
No.
Because honestly, I love the Tony Hawk series, playing him as a kid, but the first time I played Skate and I liked it where you actually flick and do
flick
tricks.
Controls are changed everything so
because
amazing.
It got so much more complicated.
You can't go back to A to jump, X to flip, and
I mean,
Y
I
to
can,
grind.
But it's just not the same.
It's just not going
to
be as fun.
And then Tony Hawk tried to come out and do the whole board thing. That board now is just kind of a mess.
Controller based skate game
Brilliant
with flick controls. They do that.
And
they have
analog trick sticks.
Analog trick sticks.
Connect.
My money.
I want to see NBA 2K16
kickflip.
Yeah.
Featuring
Battlefield. Yeah.
Hopefully that's a thing.
I really hope that's a sequel. Okay, so in concluding notes, thanks if you actually made it this far.
Props to you.
You should really leave a message because I don't think anyone's gonna make it this far. This is the first time doing this. I'm pretty sure we're gonna do a lot more. It's actually really easy to do and it's really fun. Not for Avery because he likes to edit. But luckily this doesn't require a lot of
I think
editing.
This was good. I don't know about that.
Yeah.
Like the gameplay.
But basically, in conclusion, like we said, thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching.
We will probably do some kind of something on Twitter during E3 or recording or something.
E3 is in 6 days and we're going to do a thing.
Yes.
I don't know what it is, but we're going to do a thing.
At night.